Now I'm going to change to the concept of impulse. It's not completely unrelated to what we just did. An impulse is giving someone a kick. That's what an impulse is. Our bullet gave an impulse to this block. It gave it a kick. Impulse. Impulse is a vector, and it is defined as the integral of f dt during a certain amount of time, let's say from 0 to delta t. Now, f equals ma, which is also dp dt. We have seen this now several times. Rate of change of momentum, and so I can substitute that in here. And so I find then the integral from 0 to delta t of dp dt dt, and that makes me move to the domain of momenta. So I have now simply the integral over dp from some initial momentum pi to some final momentum pf. And so that is simply the final momentum minus the initial momentum. So what an impulse does, it changes the momentum. There is a force that acts on something for a short amount of time, could be a little longer, as you will see with rockets, and that gives it a change in momentum. If we have an object that we drop on the floor, so we have an object, mass m, and we drop it on the floor, and we let it fall over a distance h, then it's going to hit the floor with a certain speed. We know it's down, the velocity, and that equals the square root of 2gh. If this were a completely elastic collision, which depends, of course, on the quality of the object, and it depends on the quality of the floor, maybe a super ball or marble would be almost completely elastic, then the ball would bounce back with that same velocity. And if that were indeed a completely elastic collision, then you can see that the impulse that the ball is given to, that is given to the ball, as the ball hits the floor is giving an impulse to the ball, and that impulse equals 2mv. The ball changes its momentum. It was first mv in this direction, and now it's mv in this direction, so the change is 2mv. So an impulse is given to the ball. Now, if the collision were completely inelastic, then the ball would just say, like a tomato, I throw a tomato on the floor, it goes, pfft, no speed anymore when it hits the ground, then, of course, the impulse would only be mv, because then it doesn't come back up. So there is no, the change in momentum is then smaller. We have here two balls that look alike. They have a mass of 0.1 kilogram. So m equals 0.1 kilogram. And I will drop them from a height of about 1.5 meters. And that gives them a speed, when they hit the floor, of about 5.5 meters per second. And so the momentum change is 2mv. So the impulse equals 2mv is about 1.1. And that would be kilograms meters per second. And that means that if the collision time is delta t seconds, that the average force acting upon this ball during the collision with the floor equals the impulse divided by delta t, because remember, that was our definition of impulse. So if we know the impulse, we get a feeling for the average force. And for the ball that I will drop on the floor, we have done fast photography. I will show you some results of the fast photography with a different ball, but nevertheless, we did it with the ball that I will drop on the floor very shortly, which is this one. That impact time is only 2 milliseconds. It's hard to believe that in 2 milliseconds, the entire collision occurs. And so if you substitute in here now 2 milliseconds, then you get for the average force 550 newtons. Just imagine, this ball has a mass of 0.1 kilogram. The weight is 1 newton. And during the impact, it weighs 550 times more. What an incredible weight increase. And the average acceleration that it experiences during the impact is 550 times G. People play tennis, and they have speeds of hundreds of miles per hour. Speeds are way higher than we have here, 10 times higher. And so the weight increase is even more. Now, if the collision were completely inelastic, so that if it were a tomato or an egg, and this one wouldn't come up, the average force would still be approximately the same, the reason being that the impulse will be half. But if the impact time were also half, and the impulse were half, then, of course, the force, the average force, will be the same. Very high, but for a shorter amount of time. So I want to show, I first want to show you now these two balls. One is almost complete elastic collision with the floor. Whether this is a complete elastic collision depends not only on this ball, whether this is a super ball, it also depends on the condition of the floor. This is not a very good floor. This is not marble. So when I drop this one, it doesn't come up to this point here. So it's not a completely elastic collision. But it bounces pretty much. So it is somewhere in completely inelastic and completely elastic. It's not bad, right? It's not bad. Now this one. Watch it. Looks alike, but it ain't. This one is completely inelastic. It goes to the floor, and it goes clunk. You see a small bounce, but that's it. And so the impact times are very short, 2 milliseconds in the case of the one that bounced his back, 1 millisecond in the case that one clunk, and their average weight is about 550 times their normal weight. I'd like to show you fast photography on not this very same ball, but on another one that we did. Let me take this out. And that is a ball that comes down with a speed of 4 meters per second. And each frame is 1 millisecond. So you will see a ruler, and the ruler indicates, has marks in centimeters. And so you will see it go in 4 milliseconds, it will go 1 centimeter. So it has a speed of 2.5 meters per second. It will hit the floor, and then we can count the number of milliseconds that it takes contact and going back up again. It's not going to be 2 milliseconds, it's a little longer, but again, impressively short. All right, we're going to make it rather dark in order to get decent quality. I'm going to turn 5 of these off, and I'm going to set the TV at 2, and now I will start this. There we go. Let's hope that that will go. Okay, there comes the ball down. These marks are in centimeters. So it is a ruler in centimeters. This is 1 centimeter. I'll rewind a little, because we were a little too late. Okay, we'll start again. So watch when it passes this mark. 1, 2, 3. You see 4 milliseconds for about 1 centimeter. So that's 2.5 meters per second. And now we'll count the number of milliseconds at impact. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and it's off. About 6, maybe 7 milliseconds. And this is no special ball. These impact times are amazingly short.